Welcome to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast, your guide in the race to financial freedom through real estate investing and sound financial practices. This podcast is for anyone interested in learning more about real estate investing, personal finances, and a new take on traditional retirement. Now, here are your hosts, Larry Fierro and Mike Moe.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast, your Monday morning motivation edition, where we follow up on our call to action from our previous episode, hit you with a little motivation to start your Monday morning off right, and we tee up our episode to come, which this episode to come, man. It's a first one for us over here at the Real Estate Marathon Podcast, isn't it?
Yes, it is, man. It's a part one of two, and it's Mr. Daniel Wood. Oh, and it was an awesome episode.
Yeah. It's so much content that we were an hour and some change into it. And we said, you know what, we got so much more to get to. We can't like leave the story untold, we can't keep going. So we got to break it off and we got to, you know, come back for part two. So part one of Mr. Daniel Wood is airing this Thursday, and he's talking about the 25 different sources of capital. So fantastic episode.
And I think about it. Yeah. An awesome episode, man.
Yeah, I think the first one we got, what did we get through, like 11 of them? So, and then we powered through the rest of them in the second part. So,
oh yeah, it was phenomenal. So, you know, he just has a world of information, you know. And on the last episode, we had Mr. Mark Willis. What was our call to action on that one?
Yeah, dude, the call to action from Mr. Willis. Mr. Willis gave us two pieces of material to dig a little bit deeper into the bank on yourself concept. So if you're interested in doing that, that was the call to action. And if I can remember correctly, it was bank on yourself, the life-changing secret to growing and protecting your financial future, which is by Pamela Yellen. You can pick that up for like $5 on Amazon. So if you're interested in this concept, go do that. It's got some good reviews as well. And then it was Financial Independence in the 21st Century by Dwayne Brunell. So
yeah. Great books, and little known secret. I actually have already called in. I've got an appointment with Mark Willis to set up my own bank on me account. So,
That's awesome.
Yeah. We're taking the information that we get here, and we wanted the listeners to know that we actually implemented ourselves. So, you know, these are good tidbits of information that we're providing you, and it's a way to secure your financial future, get the financial independence thing going on, and, you know, getting you where you got to be.
Yeah, for sure, man. And, like I said during the intro of Mr. Willis's podcast, or maybe it was the outro, I can't remember, but I'm seriously considering kind of that bank on yourself strategy as well. I'm going to do a little bit of research on my own and see if it's a good tool to pull out of the tool belt. And I'm going to have to pick your brain a little bit after you go through it too. So that's awesome.
Oh yeah, it's phenomenal. You know, and I had a nice conversation with him on the phone, and it's so much information. And he even filled me in a little bit more on the actual setup of it. And it's just it's a win-win-win for everybody.
It's awesome, man. We're going to have to go. We're going to take, a good 40 minutes into a deep dive of your experience once you're through this. So that's a teaser right there. We're going to have to make sure we do that once you get through this process.
Cool. Well, this Monday morning motivation, man, this is something that that you've wanted to do for a little bit now.
Yeah, well, we touched on it a few times, right? And it's just the importance of a plan. We talked about how goals are so important, but goals without a plan, you know, the likelihood of you getting there is not very high, right? And, you know, I had a vacation a couple weeks ago and back in the middle of August, and a couple weeks after the vacation, I was just in a funk, man. And I realized why. It's because I didn't get back to like my normal planning sessions that I usually do on a regular basis, which is, you know, sitting down Sunday night and planning out kind of like the big strategic goals that you want to do for the week, which ladder up to, you know, those big strategic goals that you want to do for the month, which ladder up to the quarter. So it's really like, what are your massive, massive goals that you want to achieve in the next, say, 3 years? And just laddering all those back to yearly goals, quarterly goals, monthly goals, and then weekly goals. Like, what's your plan to achieve those, right? So if you don't have a plan, man, you're not going to get there. So it's the importance of a plan that is what we got for you.
So it's basically finding your end goal and then reverse engineering it back to today.
Yeah, dude. What's your, I'm not going to steal the line from Brandon Turner, but I will anyways, I'll give him credit for it. What's your most important next step, right? Like, you don't have to eat an elephant all at once, right? That's the cliche. You do it one bite at a time. So what is your most important next step to your goal? But if you think about like, what's my most important step to my 3-year goal? Well, that's like crazy. Like, I can't even contemplate, I can't even like comprehend what that would be. But if you can ladder that back to a year, ladder that back to a quarter, and then you're down to the, you get to the weekly standpoint, well, that's easier. Like that's just, you know, a couple, see this thing on the whiteboard back here? It's a couple check boxes back there for the weekly goals, right? And then we're making progress.
That's it. That's it. You know, and little steps can get you where you got to be. You just got to make sure that if you're doing, like Brandon Turger said, that next major step that you need, the next important step.
So. Yeah. Consistency in these plans, man, is so much more effective than like your short burst of effort, you know? So it's,
I guarantee you every millionaire and billionaire out there started one step at a time, you know, just taking little bits and pieces at a time and built it all and stacked that house of cards right up and got successful with it. So
stacking it high, man.
That's it. Boom. That's it. So next week we got Daniel Wood with the Momentum Property Education coming on, talking about the 25 different sources of financing, 11 of them. And then the following week we'll have the other 14. And that's definitely a must-see one because he brought up some interesting points that I didn't even know about with the different sources of financing. So we've actually started looking into a couple of them ourselves on how to get financing for your rental properties.
Absolutely, man. Yeah, Daniel Wood, part one. And on that, is, you know, talking about financing, you know, we are about 6 weeks, depending on when you're listening to this, but we are about 6 weeks away from the launch of the Seller Financing University from Real Estate Marathon Podcast, right? So we might as well drop that little bomb here as well as we're wrapping up Monday Morning Motivation. But pretty quickly, we're going to have a course available as we're going to dive into the deep details of basically how you built your entire portfolio without even involving a bank, right? So we're going to go nitty gritty on seller financing, how every deal and every seller has the opportunity for seller financing and teach people A to Z how to do it.
Yeah, I'm excited for the course, but I'm also excited to include some coaching sessions with the course, you know, trying to actually put people in contact with us and walk them through how to actually do these deals step by step by step. So
exactly.
That's huge.
That'll be
very
fun.
Excited for this.
So stay tuned, everybody, on how to sign up for that. Should be in the next end of October. So 6 weeks here, we got that coming. So, All right. Anything else from you, man?
No, man, I'm good to go. We're still camping and we're going to have a good time. And everybody, make sure that you have a great week this week.
Awesome. All right. Thank you guys for tuning in to another episode of the Real Estate Marathon Podcast. We'll see you next time.
Take care.
Thanks for listening to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast. If you found value in any of the content from this show, consider supporting us in the following ways. Subscribe to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast. Leave a rating and review. Continue the conversation with like-minded individuals on social media by heading over to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast Facebook group or follow us on Instagram and Twitter @Real Estate Marathon Podcast.